Assalamualaikum students, welcome to another video from my channel, that is UA Coach 127.0.0.1. Students, as you know from my channel, you learn about different CTF from TryHackMe platform, and today I'm going to show you another CTF from TryHackMe, and this is related to the junior penetration tester section, and the walkthrough that I'm going to work is command injection. Students, definitely you heard about the command injection before that. But if you not heard about the command injection before, then I assured you after my this lecture, you can have a lot of knowledge about command injection. So keep in touch with me during my whole lecture with your full attention. And before start my lecture, I would like to say you kindly subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to get the notification of all my upcoming videos. So without wasting time, I'm going to start. I will move to my browser, and here you can see my target machine and my victim machine both are running, and I will move step by step. Obviously you should move step by step, and from the task one, here you can see introduction, and in this room we are going to covering the web vulnerabilities. It's a command injection is a website vulnerabilities, and after this room, students, you are able to discover the command injection vulnerabilities, and you will also learn about how to test and exploit these vulnerabilities using different payloads designed for different OS. And you also be able to prevent these vulnerabilities in an application. Lastly, students, you will get to apply theory into practice learning in the practical at the end of this room. Okay. A command injection vulnerabilities is also known as a RCE, remote code execution, because an attacker can trick the application in executing a series of payload that they provided. Students, the another name of command injection is RCE, remote code execution. Okay, it's also known as RCE, and students, the attacker can take advantage of this vulnerabilities and can directly interact with the vulnerable system. Here you can see it's very risky that attacker can directly interact with the vulnerable system. For example, the attacker can read system or user file, user data, and things of that nature. Being an attacker can interact directly, when interact directly to the system, then obviously he can do all these things. Okay, for example, the attacker may be able to use this command, who I am, in order to know about the user account of vulnerable machine. Okay, read me, done. Let's move to the task 2, that is the discovering command injection. How you can actually discover the command injection? Okay, this vulnerability exists because application often use function in programming language such as PHP, Python, Node.js to pass data to make system. Students, basically here a code is present. This is the code, and the application stored MP3 files in a directory container on the operating system. And guys, basically here a lot of theory present. Right now I'm not going to bore you in order to read all theory. You should read all details by your own in order to clear your concept. I will just show you practical. Okay, let's move to the question. The first question is that what variable store the user input in the PHP code in this task. Here you can see the variable that actually stored result is title. It's a variable that are using to store result. What HTTP method is used to retrieve data submitted by user in PHP code? Here you can see from this image, if I check, the method that is used is get method. Here you can see get. So this is the method that will use to retrieve data submitted by a user. Okay guys, if I want to execute the id command in the Python code snippet, what route would I need to visit? Students, actually you need to visit this route in order to execute the id command, that is slash and then the command name. You can use any command by slash id, slash who I am, slash cat etc, password. So this is all about how you can actually discover the command injection. Let's move to the task 3, exploiting command injection. How you can actually exploit command injection? There are different ways and different techniques. Okay, Application that use user input to populated system commands with data can often be combined in unintended behavior. Students, basically to perform command injection, you can combine two commands by using different operators. The operators that you can actually use is semicolon, colon, and double and will combine two or more system commands in order to perform command injection. Okay, command injection can be detected in mostly of two ways. One is blind and other than is verbose command injection. Okay, definitely you should read all these theory, and here different commands are present, and the theory about these command are also present here. Okay, right now I'm not going all these commands. Definitely you will read. I have useful payloads. Here you can see I have compiled some valuable payloads for both Linux and Windows in below list. Payload is WhoAmI. Guys, if you used WhoAmI payload in Kali Linux, definitely it will show user information about the targeting machine. If you use ls, it will show all the content of any directory. Okay, I'm going to open my terminal. If I typed here ls and hit enter, here you can see it display the content of present working directory. If I move to the cd documents and ls, and in this way you can use ls. Okay, if I typed here WhoAmI and enter, it show me the user. Currently the user is root. Okay, ping, this command will invoke the application to hang. This will be useful in testing an application for blind injection. Okay, you can use the ping command for blind injection. Sleep, this is another useful payload in testing an application for blind injection, and where the machine does not have ping installed. You can also use netcat command in order to grab the banners. Windows payloads are also present here. WhoAmI, in order to check the information about user. Dir, to show the content of any directory. Ping, you can use to check either the host is alive or not. And you can also use timeout payload for blind injection. Okay, what payload would I use? If I wanted to determine what user application is running in? Obviously WhoAmI is the payload. What popular network tool would I use to test for blind command injection in Linux? Here you can see for blind injection I can use ping command. Which payload would I use to test a Windows machine for blind command injection? Here you can see timeout. This command you can actually use for blind command injection in Windows. Okay, let's move to the task 4, that is remediating command injection. Okay, here some vulnerable functions are present here, and input sanitization. Sanitizing any input from a user that an application uses, it's a great way to prevent. Basically, in order to prevent from command injection, the user input should be sanitized. Okay, what is the term for the process of cleaning user input that is provided to an application? Sanitization is the term for the process of cleaning user input. Okay, students, it's time to do some practical work, and in task 5, I'm going to show how you can actually perform command injection. Your machine should be running, and I will move to my browser window, and let's browse this vulnerable machine. Okay, here see input box is present here. Obviously I can execute some command here. If I typed here 127.0.0.1, and then I will use here semicolon, and now if I type here pwd, see here it will currently show me that you are currently located here. Okay, if I check here cat etc password and hit enter. See, here it will display me all the user of this vulnerable machine. I can actually right now execute two commands. One command is this one, that is 127.0.0.1. The rest of other command is this one, and I separate both command by using semicolon. Okay, you can also use this cheat sheet in order to perform different tasks. It's a command injection payload list from GitHub. See here, all these commands you can use. Okay, I'm going to copy simply any command. If I move to this input box and if I paste this here and hit enter. Okay, right now this command is not executed. Let me show you another one. Okay, let's try this one. It show me the result of the used command. Okay, the first question is that find the content of the flag located in the home tryhackme flag dot. You can use a variety of payloads in order to find your flag. What user is this application running as? Okay, if I typed here 127.0, in order to fetch the user, definitely guys, you know, you can use this command. If I click execute and let me show you, it will actually display all the user. Okay, if I want to know about the current user, I will type here 127.0.0.1, and now if I type here who am I and hit enter, see, it show me the current user is this one, that is www.data. So the answer is this one. What the content of the flag located in this, that is home try hack me. Okay, it's time to find the flag. Let me show you. If I typed here 127.0.0.1 and then semicolon, and now if I typed here slash home slash try hack me slash flag, let's see what it can display to me. Okay, right now it not display flag to me. If I type here, obviously if I want to check the content, then definitely I should type here cat and hit enter. Let's see. Okay, 127. If I use and sign and hit enter. Okay, see here, I'm finally successfully fetched the flag. That is this one. Okay, in task 6 conclusion. Well done for making it to the end of this room. To recap, we learned for the following elements of this of the command injection. You learn about how to discover the command injection vulnerabilities. You learn how to test and exploit this vulnerability using different payloads. You also learn about how to actually prevent from this vulnerabilities. And at the end, you do some practical example. So students, in this way, you can actually execute multiple commands by using by separating these commands, semicolon, colon, and operator, and you can successfully perform command injection. Students, this is all about my today lecture. In this lecture, you learn about command injection. Hope so, you will do practice about it. I will come to you with my new lecture, with my new CTF. Till that, Allah Hafiz and take care.